It's time for the Daily Stand-Up Podcast, presented by Agile Dad with your host, Lee Henson. Without any further ado, let's get started. In every one of my training classes, whether it's Scrum Master or Product Owner, I always take an opportunity to talk about backlog item creation. Now, I don't spend as much time in a Scrum Master class as I do in a Product Owner class, for obvious reasons, but we do talk about methods for stack rank ordering, methods for prioritization, and how these intertwine, because there's some interesting things. So let me explain. Over the years, what I've discovered is there's three different ways that organizations choose to prioritize work. The first method is strictly based on priority, where they go in and they talk about whether things are high, medium, or low priority based on the strategy or value they'll add from a business perspective. Now, this is troublesome because when this happens, people are quick to point out that everything is either high, or really, really high. Bow, wow, wow, yippee-yo, yippee-yay, right? No, pun intended. No, but it's just everything and everyone can't be high. We can't just say everything's high. So I needed to get to the bottom of why people said this. And what we discovered is that people said things were high priority because what they were really trying to do is compare the word priority with importance. And it felt like if they said something was medium or low priority, that that would be an admission that it's unimportant. And I'm here to tell you today that's simply not the case. It's not true. When people say something, and I mean, I think I understand the threat. When was the last time someone came to you and said, "Hey, Luke, I've got this really unimportant, these unimportant items I need you to get addressed or I need you to work on. When can you get to these unimportant things?" You know, nobody ever says that. And I think that if everything is going to be high priority, what they're really trying to say is that everything is important. So I think that the word priority needs to be better associated with urgency, and that you could say, out of all these really important things you've asked us to do, which ones are most critical or most urgent? And I think that if you find ways to limit the number of high urgency things that you're working on with the understanding that everything is important, what it'll do is it'll create an atmosphere where the team better understands strategic alignment with the organization and they understand priority and how priority works, knowing that everything they're being asked for is important, but also knowing that we're taking the time to address urgency. So one method for prioritization is urgency. The second method of prioritization is based on technological feasibility. Now, this makes a lot of sense if you're building a technical app. You want to make sure you have an architecture, infrastructure, database setup, you know, all ready to go before you dive into the nuts and bolts of the finite pieces of what you're trying to do, right? You need to make sure infrastructure and architecture is in place. You need to make sure that you're building things in a sensible order. You need to be sure that you're addressing any kind of technical prioritization issues. So when people do this, oftentimes they'll use just simple t-shirt sizes based on the scope or complexity of the scope that they're working on. And I don't care if you use t-shirt sizes, dog sizes, vegetable sizes, monument sizes. You know, I've seen so many different methods. I don't really care which one you use, but I want you to size up the work somehow. And that's going to give us a technological awareness about, you know, the scope of what we're trying to do. And then as part of that scope, we can also capture whether or not it's something that we need to, you know, address right this very minute, or if it's something that is technical but can wait, you know, we can also use that. So I guess what I'm trying to say is the second method of sorting could be just based on technological awareness and technological feasibility, which makes sense. The third method of sorting is Moscow. Now, Moscow was created by Mike Comb, and it's, of course, the MSC&W, where he's talking about must have, should have, could have, and would not, right? Would not or won't have. And the way he categorized these is must have are the most vital things that you just can't live without. Should have are things you strongly consider as important, but they're not vital. Could have are things that you could have them, you could not have them. They're nice to have, but they're not a big deal. And won't have are things to provide little or no value that you literally can give up on. I don't know about you, but I had a problem with won't have. So I talked to Mike about this. I was like, why would I even label things with that? Why would I even keep track? Why would I even dedicate any time to things that I had little or no value that I want to give up on? You know, it just didn't make sense to me. I mean, I can keep a list of those, but I don't think I need to do more than that. And Mike said, good point. So I kind of twisted that one to be would like. And the point that I want to make out about Moscow is I aim this more towards a consumer perspective. So if you are the end recipient of my product or service, or you are the consumer, must have is a deal breaker. If I don't have that, you're going to go to a different place, a different vendor to get that product or service. A should have isn't necessarily a deal breaker, but it's something that's really important for you to address. A could have is one of those things where it really doesn't matter one way or the other. We can get it addressed and or not get it addressed, and it's not going to impact you positively or negatively. And a would like is, you know, I got a fever, and the only thing that can cure this fever is more cowbell. Explore the space, right? You know, and I know that's kind of funny. But it's if you could start the sentence with, you know, it would really be cool. Or if you have the Kano model and you're identifying pleasers, those are would likes. And the reason why I want to cause or draw attention to those is because I think it's important for us to consider those, because I think every sprint you need at least one, something to get the customer engaged and something to keep them happy and thoroughly ready to review or do the things that you want to do with them. So it helps you tie your understanding of the consumer's needs to what they really need and allows you to sort using that method. Now, I know what you're thinking. Lee, you just gave us three different areas to sort by. That's kind of messed up. Actually, it's not. If you triangulate and you use Moscow as your primary sort, priority as your secondary sort, and then size as your tertiary sort, you can literally write an algorithm that will do what's called objective stack ranking. So OSR, objective stack ranking, will allow you to see based on all three of those criteria what order these things should be done in, making certain that we do all of our must-have highs first and making sure that we reserve, you know, the lowest part of the backlog for things that are could have and low priority. But it allows us to set some type of stack rank order that we can go back and we can adjust and adapt, and we can pop a would like in every sprint to make sure that we keep the crowd continuously happy. But I think that it's important for us to look up and adjust and say, hey, we can't just sort based on what the consumer's needs are. We can't sort just based on what the strategic priority is. And it's not wise to sort just based on technological feasibility. I mean, while you do need, you know, the car, you do need the horse before the cart, right, in order to go somewhere, it's important for you to understand that that shouldn't be the only driving force behind prioritization. And I think that as more companies start to understand this, they're going to become better at prioritization and it's going to make sense. So I guess what I'm trying to say is Moscow has come a long way and it really is important. And it's something that we should consider when we're prioritizing our backlog. But my recommendation is to consider all three, do a triangulation, get an objective stack rank order, and then move from there. So that's going to do it for today. I hope you all enjoyed this episode. And as always, if you have a topic you'd like to hear us talk about, reach out to us, learn more at agiledad.com. We'd love to cover your topic. And as always, we encourage you to stay healthy, stay well, and stay agile, my friends. Until next time, do take care.